The electrical stimulation is complete. Having traced your brain's activity while you were working, your brain was stimulated with small electrical charges to improve your engineering skills. Judging by the result, it didn't work and caused a number of hallucinations. However, it was entertaining. You still can't get past the radiation, but I will mark the coordinates of the rescuers for useless motivation. The largest condom in the world, and also an emission of gas, most likely oxygen, are detected ahead. There's no data on the condom being suitable for an oxygen reservoir, but you can try to construct a simple balloon for distracting yourself from fatal thoughts. marking corresponds to the water tanks. The service supply compartment. Almost intact. They usually install oxygen stations here. You would be in luck if you managed to get inside. A damaged door scanner. You can scan the scanner with a scanner to record the scanner's damage data to the scanner's scanner protection system for emergency depressurization of the compartment. You will need a scanner. I used the word scanner 8 times. Gas is fed through these pipes. There can be no mistake here. This is working autonomous oxygen station. It can... You must carefully remove the station by removing two... You must carefully remove the station by removing two... screws. Anyway, this doesn't matter anymore. At least now you have an understanding of how to assemble one. You have a set of its parts and a light taste of despair. lot of various goods were transported in the cargo holds of the liner unnamed. The Global Funeral Agency rented only a small part of the ship's space in the framework of the advertising company and has nothing to do with these goods. The shuttle's plating is blue. These are the rescuers. Given that the evacuation shuttles have increased strength, the impact force must have been incredible. The rescuer spacesuits are like funerary ones, but I always wanted to learn how their flashlights work as they don't require recharging. I propose we loot the corpse for scientific purposes. The shuttle was flooded with paint during the crash. Even the service center wouldn't be able to clean it from the inside. It's impossible to repair it. The paint itself also has no value after freezing. The safe is private property, and the Global Funeral Agency is indifferent to the fact of its opening. The Breathedge Global Funeral Agency, we care about your reputation.
Bye.
It's probably the owner of the shuttle with paint. He was engaged in illegal pumping during the crash, judging by the traces of paint on his hands and a huge hose. Stuck to his face.